Hello!
Welcome to my channel of my adventures in planners, organization, books, homeschool, homesteading, travel, and whatever else I find worth sharing. Today I want to show you how I art journal, junk journal, and memory keep all in one place. So the important thing to realize is that I do my junk journaling and memory keeping here seasonally. So this is for spring and summer. I have a separate place where I do this type of activity for autumn, Christmas, and winter memory keeping. So first I wanted to show you, I have charms. I made these charms. You can buy charms on Etsy. There's a lot of really great shops, but I found these porcelain owls on Amazon, and I found some matching beads, and I just strung it on using really thin elastic, and I just used those to make those, and it really was not that hard. This is a Chic Sparrow Pemberley Tenerife Sea Wide, which I know is a mouthful, but it is a leather, a very pebbled leather, cahier size. I have a peach pen gem that I use when I'm just writing information down, not necessarily junk journaling or art journaling. So I'm just gonna go ahead and dive in. I have laminated some curated paper goods that I get from the Happy Marigold on Etsy, and I just wrap it in washi. I have my washi tape dispenser here, and I just pull off some seasonal pieces and wrap it on the card so that I can take it with me and have it anywhere in these card slots. We made this paper in homeschool this year, so I laminated that and wrapped that as well with some washi. I have some old vintage cards that I keep in here just as decoration. This is a free printable on Stone Soup for Five. So one thing that I do is a little bit of bullet journaling in here, and I like to use her doodles, and so she has these free printables, so I went ahead and printed them out, double-sided, and I just keep them in here. So one thing to note is I am not a professional artist. I follow a couple people online, so virtual mentors. I follow Allie Brown. She's, I believe, Allie Brownie on social media, and also Celeste, and Celeste is Precious to Me on social media. And so I've watched their videos and some Periscopes and follow them on Instagram. And then, like I said, I use cheats like this to be able to art journal. So I'm not a professional. I just enjoy doing it, and it's a really great creative outlet for me. So I also get free printables off of Coco Daisy. So this was a free printable. She also has monthly bookmarks. So I laminate them, I use them for that month in anything that I'm reading, and then I store them, since this is a seasonal journal, I store them in here, and it actually helps keep the leather, although Pemberley's not super floppy, it does keep the leather a little bit more structured. So I got this from Planner Fix, an Etsy shop. These I think were from Peachy Cheap Sticker Kit. Like I said, this was a Coco Daisy printable. And so this is a Moleskine that I got from Target. I like the purple shade for the spring. And so because, like I said, I do a little bit of bullet journaling, this is my index in the front, and it tells you, you know, what holidays in the season I have at what page. And it's just nothing fancy, just this is where I would go for, you know, May Day is page 12. So this is an example of how I do the junk journaling and the art journaling. So I have like St. Patrick's Day, I just have some washi tape, and then next year when I come back to St. Patrick's Day, I can see, remember, oh, this is what we say is our prayer. This is our menu that we have on St. Patrick's Day. These are some tip-ins. I got this free from Coco Daisy. This, I think, was a We Are Memory Keepers booklet that they sell journaling cards in, and I just used washi tape to tip it in. And I put activities that we like to do for St. Patrick's Day, books that we like to read, and I just use the colors of that particular season, the orange and the green. I also use just placeholders so that next year when I come back to this book, if we do something new or different, then I can record it and keep it in here. So I just wanted to leave a few extra pages. For instance, this is where I want to start recording rainbows that we see and when. So I have that page there. So here's Easter, for instance. So I'm recording, this is what we bake. This tip-in is from Planner Perfect, which is Jenny Penton. You can find her on social media, and I can link her below also. And the menu that we usually have at Easter, the books that we read. This is our memories of what we do on Easter. So each year, and I'll write the year in there, this is what we've done for Easter. And you can see the junk journaling. I stamped here. I added in a doily, and it's just a creative outlet. This started the month of April, and as I said, it is a creative outlet. So I typically will get out all of my art supplies. I keep plastic tubs by season, and I may do a video on how I organize my supplies. But I have a little thin plastic tub that I keep all of my paper supplies in and washi for that season, and I pull that out, put it out on the table, and my kids and I just do have an afternoon, like a Sunday afternoon, of creative outlet. It's a great bonding experience with them, and we have so much fun, and I enjoy it. So for instance, here's April. I used the Wink of Stella brush. This is the is a tip-in. I stamped a fox because we saw a fox right at the early April, and that led me to think, oh, maybe I should record some of the animals that we see and where we see them. So I did that. This is fabric. This is paper, stamping. So again, a big mix, which makes it kind of the junk journal feeling. So just want to show a couple things. This is a Lumiere paint that's very shimmery. So this is what we do on Earth Day, and I have written down the dates down here so that we can remember that. These are dates that we might go on. And so I just record, you know, we got baby chicks, so I wrote down what chicks we got and some health treatments that we give them, photos and animals that we've seen when we go to the mountains, spring books. And so you can see, it's just meant we're growing herbs, and so I have my list there. So you can see, I just will put in all of the pegs in that season, and then I'll be able to bring this book out again next year and record, this is what we did this year for Mother's Day, this is what we ended up doing next year. And so I use this not only as a creative outlet, and you can see there's space. I can still add to this and decorate it more and add paint if I want to again next year. But it's a place for me to record then, in addition to creative outlet, what we've done for that season. And it becomes kind of a book that I can pass on to my kids at some point. I have an Ollie clip to kind of mark where I am in the book. I have an Annie Plans printable in here for the year, just so they can keep track of that. And then I would have the summer book, which I haven't gotten into yet. And I just keep some Molly and Rex cards from Michaels in here and some printables from Coco Daisy. Again, partially to keep structure for the leather, also because I like the embellishments. You can see I have Grumpy Bear there. I did want to show you some of the supplies that I use for art journaling, and maybe at some point I can do a, you know, art journaling video. Again, I'm not a professional, but it's something I enjoy doing. So if you are using paint, you want to be able to use this. You put this down on your page so that it doesn't bleed through, and you can use the Wink of Stella. You can use, I really like the gelatos. So there's the gelatos. And what I do with those is you can just color with them. It almost feels like a pastel kind of a supply. And then I like to use these water brushes. The water is contained inside of this brush, and then you just can, after you've used the gelatos, just have water go over it. You can do the same thing with watercolor, but this is, I love doing the gelatos. It's fun. So I did want to show you my kit really quickly. This is my grandfather made this as a gardening kit years ago, and I went ahead and just repurposed it for all of my art supplies. And I love it. I can just put it right on the table. He's got holes in there, so I have my awl and all kinds of things in there. So I do love repurposing old vintage things for new purposes. So hope you enjoyed. If you liked the video, please like below and subscribe to see more of this. And until next time,